Dear 25, it 48 a.m. and the new celebrity housemates have arrived by Big Brother Carl.
Oh, did somebody mention Carl? Oh, yeah. Oh, hello, Simon. Or can I call you Daddy?
8:49 a.m. The housemates are having donuts for breakfast.
Ah, did somebody mention donuts?
Donuts. Mmm, is there anything they can't do? Mmm.
Marge!
Oh, Homer, what are you talking about? Are you talking about donuts again, homie? Homie!
We'll be back after the break.
I've had an accident. And I think I'm entitled to some compensation.
9:49 a.m. Time to find out if he's got the X Factor.
You look like a pop star. You sound like a pop star. I'm putting you through. But Sharon, Nicole, we need to find out the thoughts of one final judge, Simon.
Okay, let me stop you there.
Thank you!
And here he is, please welcome John Clegg!
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to face the music!
Oh, for the love of dogs, will you be quiet? Dead, I'll tell you. Hey, look at her at the front, I face like a bulldog chewing a wasp. Hey, I'm the most famous scouser in Britain.
I think you find, did I? I'm the most famous scouser in the country. Yeah, and I've got even whiter teeth than Simon.
Hello, yes, it's me. I'm here on my favourite country of them all. It's Great Britain! But I'll be honest with you. I'm really enjoying the show, but I think we need a bearded lady from Austria.
Oh, and welcome to Take Me Out. So, Amanda, Alicia, no likey, no lighty.
Well, I tell you what, you look at the game you go and see, that's absolutely terrible. Tell me the minute of the goal. I mean, look at that. Absolutely brilliant. Passing move. He's got great feet. Time and again and again and again. He really did bend it like Beckham.
Actually, I think you'll find there's only one person who can bend it like Beckham, and that's me at the end of the day. I mean, at the end of the day, it's about the end of the day, coming at the end of the day, at the end of the day, at the end of the day, really, at the end of the day, at the end of the day, isn't that right, Victoria, at the end of the day, here, at the end of the day. Compassamirka.com, compassamirka.com.
Oh, yes.
An accident.
Welcome to Britain's Got Talent. So, don't forget to vote for John Clegg.
That's right, don't forget to vote for John Clegg.
If you think John Clegg should go through to the final of Britain's Got Talent, then pick up the phone and vote.
Come on.
Well, listen, the best of all, we know how hard that job can be.
How are you?
I'm very good. How are you, Simon?
I'm great, thank you. And what's your name?
My name's Danny Posthill. I'm a comedy impressionist.
You do that full time?
I do, yeah. I do the comedy clubs and after dinners and anywhere else that
And what
pay
is
me.
The club circuit like now? Is it good?
The money's not brilliant. You've got to do a lot of gigs to make your money up, you know.
Daniel, well, good luck.
Thank you very much, Simon. I was talking to a very good friend of mine, very funny guy. All the way from Liverpool, you know, Mr. John Bishop. I've just been doing a celebrity episode of Come Down With Me. And I was on there with Gary Barlow, and I was on there with David Beckham. I tell you what, David, you know what? You are an absolutely fantastic, phenomenal footballer, you know, but there is a question I've been meaning to ask you now for a long, long time. Which is because you got such a funny voice. Have you ever thought about being a stand-up comedian?
You know, people have often said to me, you know, about stand-up comedy, and I've often thought to myself, if I speed my voice up a little bit more, eventually I will turn into Michael McIntyre. Yes, ladies and gentlemen! What I like about Michael is he's very middle-class. I love middle-class people. Middle-class people tend to do this thing where they say a bad word in front of a good word to make the good word sound even better than what it actually is.
Okay.
Michael would say something like, yes, it was terribly exciting, yes. It wasn't just exciting, it was terribly exciting. I used the word terribly in front of exciting to make exciting sound even more exciting. I can see you all now looking at me now. You're all looking at me thinking, I can't believe it. I can't believe it. It's Michael McIntyre's face with Harry Hill's head. It's a nightmare.
Thank you very much and good night. Cheers, thank you.
If Michael was even more posh. Because if Michael McIntyre was even more posh, eventually he will sound like Jimmy Carr. What all about Jimmy Carr's after every joke? He looks surprised. So what I'm going to do for you now, ladies and gentlemen, is tell you a joke as Jimmy Carr. When I finish telling the joke, do the surprise look. So here we go. Last time I was on Britain's Got Talent, it was fantastic. David says fantastic. Alicia says fantastic. Amanda says fantastic. Simon says, put your hands on your head. Now with the figures, you can't do Jimmy and Lee Allen now, can you? Do you know what I mean? Now, honestly. Honestly, someone said to me, Alan, go on Britain's Got Talent. I thought, I'll go on there as a comedian and someone will put me in an eight-piece boy band. No, because I've just been doing a celebrity episode of Embarrassing Bodies. Oh, yeah. Because I've got this condition where after every sentence I look like I'm going to throw up. Now, because Sarah Millican was there as well. Because what I like about Sarah Millican is she sounds like she's got a little mouse inside of an inch, you know. Oh, thank you very much, Pat. It's lovely, isn't it?
It's really nice, actually. I see a gentleman at the front row is actually undressing me with his eyes. Yeah. Yeah, he's got a little smile on his face. Now, haven't you, pet? Yeah. As he just found a Twix down my bra. Yeah. Which is really lovely, actually, because sometimes I don't wear a bra. Yeah. A bit like Amanda tonight. By the way, pet, it's rude to point. Tell me, Brad, to make sure I've got some emergency food. Just in case I end up in the jungle. With Elto over there. So, welcome back to I'm a Celebrity. Get me out of here. Where our favourite forgotten about celebrities will take part in a 3-week audition for an Iceland advert. I knew he was going to do you. I knew it. That's right. Every single impressionist comes on this show and does an impression of little old me. And every time they do, I always pull this open mouth face. I look like Pudsey the dog gagging for a biscuit. Ladies and gentlemen, you've been fantastic. Good night. So, welcome to Take Me Out, the show where people get humiliated by getting buzzed on national television. Who would want to do that? So, without further ado, let's move over to RTV2 and let the celebrities see the juice. So, welcome to another episode of Celebrity Jolt. I must say, Amanda and Alicia, you were both looking absolutely bang tidy. I must say, if you were single and I was single, I would still be single. So we're going to move over now to my favourite guest. It's Mr. Johnny Vegas. So, Johnny, is it true you like a drink? Yeah, of course it is. I love a drink, me. I drink far too much. Some bloke tried to put me off. He'd done a demonstration. He had a glass of water and a glass of whiskey, and he had this worm. He put the worm in the glass of water, pulled the worm out, the worm was still alive. He put the worm in the glass of whiskey, pulled the worm out, the worm was dead. He said, Mr. Vegas, do you understand the model of my demonstration? I said, yeah, drink plenty of whiskey and you won't get worms. As we all know, John is a very close friend of mine, as we worked before on Fruit Keyhole. So, who lives in a house like this? 9:45 p.m. Lee Evans is in the Big Brother house, trying to understand what Dara O'Brien is trying to say. Obviously, people may know me from the program Mock the Week. Basically, when I get to the end of my sentences, I slow down like that. And obviously, you are a very, very energetic comedian. Can you not ever stand still? Yeah, you know, because I get really nervous all the time. Do you know what I mean? But it's mad, you know, I get really nervous all the time, do you know what I mean? Like, whenever I see anyone sexy, I start to shake, you know. Yeah, hello, Amanda. Yeah, hello, Alicia. Hello, Simon. Hey, I knew he was going to do that. Ah! That's right, so did I. But I tell you what, though. What, man? I bet he doesn't do that open mouth face joke again. Because I pull this face now. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Good night.
Hello.
Hello. What's your name?
I'm Darren.
Tell me, do you have a day job?
I'm a voiceover artist, actually.
Oh, for commercials and things?
Yeah.
What product would we know your voice from mostly on the radio?
I am an IAMS cad.
Is this what your act is going to be this evening?
Tonight I'm going to do a few celebrity impressions for you.
I love them.
Brilliant. OK, when you're ready, off you go.
Thank you.
Oh, I'm so excited.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to face the the impressions.
Actually, doing the X Factor guy, all you have to do is right at the very end, roar like a lion.
Simon Cowell.
Thank you. And here we can witness a whole plethora of strange and fascinating creatures.
That's good.
Nice.
Yes!
The obligatory wild pack of street dancers and the balding, middle-aged car enthusiast.
Look at the body on this. I love the sexy curves, the exquisite contours, but most importantly, the two big airbags.
So actually, to do Jeremy, you just have to get a few key points in.
You have to start low, go up like this, pause, and go back down like this. So once you've got your Jeremy, it's very easy
to slip into God. It's all about working it, and looking good.
Hey, 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 big boy, yes, look at me, hey, well done. Yes, to do Gordon, you have to jump up and down as if you're absolutely busting for the toilet, yes? And another guy that also talks in quite a breathy manner who's not a million miles away, ladies and gentlemen.
Do an impression of
what are you doing?
Huh?
What are you doing?
He also talks very pointed and staccato is this guy. Now, to do your Declan Donnelly, what you have to do is always look like you're on the verge of laughing out loud while sharing a cheeky little in-joke with members of the crew. Gary, on camera two, he gets it.
No one ever tries to do me. Who's this?
If Declan Donnelly ever decided if Declan decided to go into politics, what you'd have to do is send him to Eton, lower his voice, and then you would have this chap. Now, to do your Boris, you have to talk at different speeds whilst looking like you've been up all night downing tequila in a bush. Good night. Thank you.
Welcome to From Celebrity Restaurant Kale! Thought I'd title myself. Wow, look at that lady. She's got lovely bangers and mash. Right, let me introduce Dick, our maitre, Geordie. Tell us what's on the menu, but be nice and short.
Nice and short, that's me. Gary on camera two, still loving it. Well, I'm too busy being utterly adorable to work in a restaurant, ladies and gentlemen. But luckily, I know someone who'll do it. So if I take a step to my right, put some gravel in the throat and a lovely big forehead. I'll just run through the specials. Filet steak drizzled in a red wine and balsamic jus. Portland crab nestled in a bed of lime and mango. Or a kangaroo's knackers. No. I don't want to hear it. Right. You had one task and you failed. Right, what I ordered was boiled potatoes. Right, but these have been dipped in very, very hot fat until they've gone lovely and crispy. You're fried. Oh, no. So,
just take another order from walking round the restaurant, holding me microphone, pretending not to know where I'm going, desperately trying to create suspense before I choose. You, sir, you look like you're enjoying your meal.
And as we all know, a Michelin star restaurant is one of the world's most unforgiving environments. And in this situation, it's important to take protein on board. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have a dead squirrel and a glass of my own pee. Hey, big boy, hey, look at me, yes, hey, hey, where's the scallops? Come on! To create, and serve successful scallops, one has to, slice, saute, and sear them sensitively so they stay succulent in the center. But, sadly, the waiter has stupidly slipped and spilt them. Oi, oi, McPartlin, hey, get over here, yes? You're about to have a kitchen nightmare.
Oh, no! Ramsay's on the rampage! Get me out of here!
Okay, take it away.
Yeah?
We clawed, we chained our hearts in vain. We jumped, but never asking why. We kissed, I fell under your spell. A love that no one could deny. What? Don't you ever say I just walked away. I will always want you.
To break your rules, all you ever did was wreck me. Yeah, you wreck me. It's slowly turn, you let me go, and now your ashes on the ground. Don't you ever say I just walked away. I will always want you.
I can't live a lie, running for my life. I will always want you.
Bring you me.
Such a difference between us and a million miles.
Hello from the other side. I must have called a thousand times to tell you I'm sorry for everything that I've done. When I call you, never seem to be home.
Hello! How are you? Did you ever make it out of that town where nothing ever happened? And it's no secret that the both of us are running out of time. So hello from the outside. I must have called it out.
for breaking your heart.
The force is strong with you. Thank you, Wemos.
We clawed, we chained our hearts in vain. We jumped, but never asking why. We kissed, I fell under your spell, a love that no one could deny. Don't you ever say I just walked away, I will always want you. I can't live a lie, running for my life, I will always want you. I came in like a wrecking ball, sky, and now you're not coming down. It's so certain you let me burn, and now ashes on the ground. Don't you ever say I just walked away, I will always want you. I can't lie, running for my life, I will always want you.
I know, Reggie! Reggie!
Thank you. Thank you.
Well done. Well done, Harry.
Hello.
Hello.
And who are you?
I'm Jess Robinson. I am 33. I'm from North London.
And what do you do as a day job?
So I'm trying to be a full-time performer, but during the week I work with kids that have special needs.
Great. Tell me why you decided to enter Britain's Got Talent.
I've wanted to enter for a few years now, but I've always chickened out. but quite a lot has changed for me in the last year, so
what's happened?
Go. Oh, fun things like moving house, getting divorced, you know, good things. Exciting, fun things.
What's the act you're going to do today?
I'm going to be doing some impressions.
Oh, yes. OK, well, good luck.
I'm so nervous, it's stupid.
Deep breath.
Deep breath.
Oh, hope nerves don't get the better of her.
I hope she's good.
Choose between me, Catherine Jenkins.
Home, your baby.
fate, fate for this love. We've got a fate, fate. Well, you wouldn't recognise my voice if I sang. Life is a cabaret, old chap, you know it is. And I love a
I like pelican fly. I mean, you're so shine, I'm loving your tie. You're like slicker than the guy with a thing on his eye. Oh! You'll read, pet. Do you know, if you haven't seen much of me recently, it's because I've spent all my time looking after my little boy. And also, I've got a baby.
Lucky that my breasts are small and humble, so you don't confuse them with the mountains. Lole, lole, lole. Lole, 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 lole. Can't you see? When the rain is blowing in your face,
you're right,
and the whole world is on your case.
Oh my God, this is amazing.
I can open
my feet are killing me
to make you feel my love.
Right, so that's 4 pints of Lambrini and a packet of pork scratchings. That's Simon's order. What the rest of you having?
Waddling, 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 oh, it's me, Cliff. It's me, your Kathy, I've come home now. So cold, let me in your window wall.
If one could choose this year's lineup on the Royal Variety Show, and one can, it would be between either Snoop Doggy Dogg or this person, one's all-time favourite rapper.
Night time, short time, hook line, let's roll, let's rise! Scribble on the paper, gonna keep this tight. Here we go again, about the rave and rhyme. Let me evict you, let me ditch you, let me hit you, let me start again, let me zip you, ha ha ha!
One thinks it's an absolute banger.
My time, short time, hook line, let's rise!
First act of the year. Let's go and get them.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Palladium Theatre, I invite you to stand and welcome Her Majesty the Queen.
The Queen? What? That's why there's a throne.
Treat.
That's right, Mr. Cow. The boss is finally here. It's so good to see a member of the royal family sitting next to Simon. It's lovely to see you, Camilla. Yes. It is rare indeed for the sovereign to appear on such an insignificant occasion. But as I look down on you all, I am happy to patronize you. Queens have always patronized the arts, and the arts have relied upon the support of queens. It is with regret, ladies and gentlemen, I have noted that recently Britain's Got Talent has suffered enormously. There have been far too many below-average variety acts, and I'm not referring to Alicia Dixon. I beg your pardon. I'm sure you all agree that plastic is the modern scourge on the face of this planet. Of all the men and women of these islands, no greater innovation has been made than by our judging panel, who have stored a great amount of plastic in their faces.
Oh, cutting!
That direction.
For their services to the entertainment industry, and Dick, as well as David Williams, have been awarded OBEs. Simon, there is only one thing standing between you and the knighthood, and that's the golden buzzer. I have much pleasure, ladies and gentlemen, in declaring the search for talent in Great Britain officially open.
What a treat!
And now Her Majesty, a radiant figure in embossed satin, enters this vast auditorium, moving amongst loyal members of the great British public. On occasions such as this, she is always seen to possess dignity, grace, and above all, medicated hand wash. And now the Queen makes her way to the throne, where she will address the nation. My lords, ladies, and commoners, I am most pleased to speak to all of you this evening, and as I look out around this theatre, I see it is filled with national treasures. Sir Simon, Alicia, David, and of course, me. Sorry, Camilla. Of course, you know I jest. I've always enjoyed a good joke, like Simon's hairdresser. It is important to remember that even if you have no talent, no charisma, and an appalling dress sense, you can still be on Britain's Got Talent as a judge. Recently, we all celebrated the birth of a son to one of the nation's favorite couples. Hearty congratulations, Stacey Solomon and Joe Smash.
have so many grandchildren and great-grandchildren that Prince Philip and I struggled to remember their names. Only the other day, I said to Harry, what's the name of the one who dribbles all the time and wets the bed? And he said, Granddad. I may be 93, but I'm actually dying with the kids. I binge watch television, or as we call it, Netflix and Phil. We often lose ourselves in the box set of The Real Housewives of Windsor. But my favorite show is The Crown. It's all about one and what one gets up to. I still think they should have called it The One Show. In these troubling times, I believe we should all have confidence in this great nation. House prices may fall, but I can assure you that every single person in Britain will own a house. It's the one I live in. And you're most welcome anytime. £24 per adult and £13.50 for children. And if you're becoming bored listening to a pensioner who dresses ridiculously and is paid millions for doing absolutely nothing, maybe you shouldn't have Simon on the judging panel. Three cheers for the Queen. Hip hip. And may God bless you all.
My name's Andrew Lancaster.
All right, where are you from, Andrew?
I'm from Lancashire.
And what do you do?
I do impressions.
What's your full-time job, Andrew?
I've done a vast array of jobs.
Like what?
I worked in a biscuit factory.
And tell me why you've entered the show and what the dream is, please.
Well, I suppose the dream would be to have my own impression sketch show one day. It's a big dream, it's a big dream.
Well, that's what it's all about, Andrew. OK, well, best of luck.
Thank you very much, thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen of the United Kingdom, I, Donald J. Trump, propose some changes to the way you're doing things in your beautiful country. Yeah. Number one, your children, your greatest natural resource. I propose Professor Brian Cox educate each and every last one of them. I think it's going to go something like this.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star. How I wonder what you are. Well, actually, we do know what you are. I think it's absolutely wonderful.
Number two, I believe that your National Health Service is a beautiful thing, should be in charge by my good friend, Nigel Farage. He's gonna do a great job.
Now, wait a minute, don't do that. I mean, come on. I mean, here we are. It's funny, isn't it? You know, as soon as somebody says my name, everybody goes bonkers. You know, I think it's quite funny. I've got another job.
And finally, number three. Is it number three? I don't know. It doesn't matter. Number three, folks, your housing, you got to get that sorted out, folks. I know just the man for the job. It's Russell Brand, ladies and gentlemen. Russell, do your thing.
No, seriously, right? Yeah, I think the most important thing is, right...
No, you don't know what I'm going to say yet.
But the most important thing, I think, for this country at the moment is to get everybody in a nice little house, you know?
Because where else are you going to live? You know, I can't live in a street, can you? There's a royal wedding going to happen, you know? Not like me, though. I live in a nice big house. I love you, bye-bye!
Those are my ideas for reform in your beautiful country. If you don't like them, you're fake news. Good night, God bless you, and God bless America.
They said it had never happened, folks. They said it had never happened. But here we are, BGT. Britain's got Trump. I, Donald J. Trump, propose more ideas to bring our two beautiful nations closer together. You want to hear my ideas, folks? Idea one, I take another British bodyguard. You got knights in Britain. Knights make great bodyguards. So who better than Sir David Attenborough? He's going to do a great job.
This animal from North America is the Brontosaurus. The Brontosaurus will make being a bodyguard very difficult, as he responds almost always in a display of aggression to any sign of provocation. He does this during the day by roaring at the cameras when the sun goes down, by sitting in bed, cheeseburger in hand, and, despite his gargantuan size, by tweeting long into the night. Note his remarkably tiny hands.
And we're gonna build that cheeseburger, Sir David. Next, I want someone in charge of my show. You're in it. Britain's Got Trump. This is my show. I created it. I need someone with bigly, it's a word, bigly diplomatic skills and intelligence. It's Boris Johnson, ladies and gentlemen.
Wait, come on. I know what's going on. Yes. So, right, you work for me. So, no, wait. Right, no, come on, no more silliness. Right, so we've got Amanda held me, holding, no, Dickinson, dancing woman, Robbie Williams. Williams, Robbie Williams. Yes, no, Williams, him. No, it's the Irish bloke, lives in a castle, Louis Walsh. Yes. Jolly good, jolly good.
Something about that guy's hair I just love. Finally, folks, your Brexit. You gotta get your Brexit sorted out, folks. If you want a trade deal with China, I propose your mucho macho actor, Sean Bean, be in charge. He's a very tough cookie. He's gonna do a great job.
Under the auspices of Donald Trump, I will take my men with sword and shield to France and slay every dragon in the EU. Hey, let's just build a great big wall. Champion.
And I love it, big beautiful wall. And who's gonna pay for the wall, folks? No, not Mexico. Not Mexico, the others. Folks, these are others. It's a joke, doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. So, folks, these are my ideas to bring our two beautiful nations closer together. But I know what you're thinking. Why would such a beautiful nation want to join forces with a big-headed megalomaniac with far too much money, terrible, terrible hair, and a really weird voice? But, folks, if America wants to work with Simon Cowell, that's no problem. Good night, God bless you, and may God bless Britain's Got Trump.
And now, lords, ladies, Simon Cowells, let's meet the celebrities. Heat it!
This'll be good. I like impressions.
New swimming!
Hello! I'm Jenny Straight Poulter. That's right. There. The other day, my dentist said to me, Janet, what
good
big teeth you've got. I said, all the better for telling you to shut your blooming gob.
Well, hello, welcome back.
Yes!
got some fashion tips for Piers Morgan. It's a blue suit with two key accessories, gaffer tape for the mouth, and a paper bag for the head. That's great, isn't it? That's great. Listen, I am the JC, darling. Now, being near me is an SE, special experience vibe. So you could get your GCSEs from the Diva Baby. And hello, I'm Kirsty Allsop. Welcome to Kirsty's Vintage Homes. On today's show, I'm going to teach you how to make a cushion out of a cushion. All you're going to need is tie-dye, a car tire, 9 hours of your life that you can't get back. Then join me next week when I shall make my living from being posh, practical, and patronising. Yes, it's fair to see again. Here to ask you, please put Susie through to the next round. It will be the best performance since I played Olivia Colman in The Crown. Thank you.
So as I just said, I've been doing this for 20 years, and during lockdown, obviously, all the work stopped, and I wanted to learn a new trade. So I've been working on ventriloquism, and I think I've mastered it, so I'd like to try it out here for you tonight. So here we go, a bit of ventriloquism. This is Grandad. Everyone say hello, Grandad. You gonna say hello back? No? Why? Eh? You are? Oh. He says, because we're not 2 metres apart, he would prefer it if I would wear my mask. Is that better? Yeah, that's much better than that. That's all I do with that. But I'll probably give you the wrong impression. I want you to leave with the right impression. So I'm going to attempt for you now 20 impressions in 60 seconds, which is very hard to do. So whoever they sound like, that's who it is. So can we have 60 seconds on the clock, please?
I'm Morgan Freeman.
I gotta say, I should still be president of the United States.
Right there.
Hey, Joffy! Lucy!
Hey, homie, where are you?
Need be doing it.
Hey, 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 hiya, kid.
The Scouts Canadian, you can't understand what he says.
Absolutely fantastic, terrific.
Oh, yes, I'm a chatty man.
Oh, mother, you vile woman. Giggity, 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 all right.
Please, me, Michael, yes, you know this.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, that's flabby juice, Robin Fee.
Karen!
Cracking cheese, gummies.
Oh, yeah, we'd like to party.
And here we have the most peculiar creature.
Oh, Scooby Snatch. Gobby, gobby, go.
Oh, great.
Very good.
Yeah, well done. Well done.
Genuinely, this is the best night of my life. And as Tate that would say, this is the greatest day of my life. Let's do it. Starting off with Gary Barlow.
Hey, all right.
Today this could be the greatest thing of my life.
Stay close to me. Stay close to me. Oh,
the greatest day of our life.
So very nice to be here. Very cold today. A few days ago, I left the house. It was raining, and I had my umbrella. This man had left the house without his, so he improvised, put a supermarket carrier bag on his head to repel the rain. I couldn't resist it. As I walked past him, unexpected item in bagging area. Now, my heritage is Italian. I speak Italian. I used to watch Italian television when I was a kid to learn, and my favourite show was The Simpsons. But in Italy, every character sounded identical. So you had Homer here.
Donuts, sweet, sweet donut. I wish I had one right now.
You had Homer in Italy.
Donuts. Volevi semplicemente un donut.
You had Marge over here.
Bart, leave Lisa alone and go upstairs.
Oh, that's good.
You had Marge in Italy.
Bart. Lasci stare, vai su di sopra.
Now, I love British regional accents. I love foreign languages. So I started learning foreign languages in British regional accents. So I hope you enjoy these. I started learning German with a West Country accent.
All right.
Guten Tag.
Mein Name ist Stefano Paolini. Ich bin ein stand-up comedian and voiceover künstler.
Spanish with a Glaswegian twist.
Hola, mi nombre es Stefano Paolini. Voy soy monologuista.
Italian, but with a Northern Irish accent.
Buonasera, io mi chiamo Stefano Paolini.
Chinese with a Geordie accent.
Ni hao. Wuzhou, duli duli ole, wuzhia, Stefano Paolini.
Oh, I like that one, that's good.
French with a Brummy accent.
Bonjour, je m'appelle Stefano Paolini. Je suis un stand-up comedian, if what's your artiste.